Hello everyone, welcome to the class. Today we'll be studying about the cloud adoption considerations. So before we try to adapt to any new changes, the first question always arises is, do we really have to adapt it? Do we really need to consider that change and inculcate that change in our regular routine? The same way, the business or the organizations that are giving the services to the customers, do they really have to adapt this cloud technology? If in case they have to adapt this cloud technology, why do they need to adapt it? So this question is being answered in terms of a 5 key considerations. The first one, selection of the deployment model. Second, application suitability. Third, financial advantage. Fourth, selection of the cloud service provider. And the fifth one is service level agreements. Let's look into the first one, the selection of the deployment model. As we have already seen the various deployment models, which are a public cloud, it can be private cloud, it can be the hybrid or the community cloud. Among these clouds, which is that model the consumer has to select it? If it is public cloud, as we have already seen the advantages and disadvantages. Advantages is less capital investment, but the disadvantage is related to the network, the interoperability issues. This all has to be taken care. If I'm looking at the private cloud, it is owned by the organization, but the capital investment is huge. When it comes to the community and the hybrid, as already we know that a community is also expensive, and hybrid, it is the combination of both the private and the public, or it can be the community also. Now based on these, the business that you are been running, the organizations have to adapt either in terms of the private cloud or in terms of the public cloud. Now it is based on the organization, so it is not any restriction that they have to adapt this particular cloud itself. Now if you check in this deployment model, it is on the organization, it depends. For example, it is a business unit, a very small business unit, then they can go for the public cloud. If it is related to any government agencies or military or mission critical agencies, at that time they need to go for the private cloud. It can't be the public cloud. Here in the public cloud, the data will be compromised. If it is in case they have to share the data has to be shared with the different organization and they are merging up, at that time the best one is the community. And if in case they are looking at the combination where the data is being shared with the public and the private, then they can go with the hybrid cloud. So based on the deployment model, you can select the cloud. The second one is application suitability. Now you need to check that what type of an application you are running on which you can adapt that particular cloud. Is it the application that is a mission critical, or it is for the public services? Based on that, you need to deploy that particular cloud. If in case the application that you are running is a mission critical, right? That means it cannot be compromised. The data is very critical or it is very sensitive data. At that time, you need to go with the private cloud. So the examples are for your military systems. They can't use the public clouds. And even they don't go for even the hybrid clouds also. They go for the community clouds. And if in case there are interoperability issues also at that particular time, then those applications will not be running. So at that time, it is again a problem. And if in case there is a network traffic, right? Whenever, if it you in case you are using a public cloud, then again the application that you have been running, you need to see the network issues also. So based on the application that you are using, you need to decide that which cloud model is better for you. Now for this example, if I have to say, is we all know that Zomato, the famous online food delivery, you can see that this Zomato is been merging with the many hotels. They're providing the services to the customers. So the customer has to install that application and he can order the food from whichever hotel he wants it. The hotel what you have been looking may be having a website or may not be having a website. Here they are just going and collecting the information. That means they are not looking. Those hotels that they are coming up, they may not be having even the cloud also. Please remember, they may not be having cloud also. But some 5-star hotels and all, if you check the online Trivago applications and all, where you can see the particular hotels, the rooms and all, you are able to log in, you are able to check, and you are any person can check that one. It is looked all over the world. At that time, they are looking into the model that is been the public model. So these hotels have been come up with the adoption of the cloud. The next one is a financial advantage. This is a very important aspect where each and every organization is looking, what is the benefit or what is the profit I am going to gain after I adopt the cloud services. Now obviously we have been having, as I have already said, that there are a lot of advantages. Now when it is been there, we need to look even at the capital expenditure, that is called as CAPEX, capital expenditure, and the another one is operational expenditure, that is called as OPEX. Capital expenditure is total that how much are you going to invest, right? In terms of, it can be in terms of the servers, it can be the storage or the operating system or the equipments that you are going to buy. The operational expenditure is what all is needed extra for the maintenance of these all that you have been invested. For example, if you are taking up the servers, if you are looking into the equipments, the servers need the cooling, they need the power, they need the maintenance. When you are looking at the storage, you need the backup for this one, right? So based on the capital expenditure for the resources you have been taken, and these resources have to be maintained properly and give the services, which is your operational expenditure. So these both have to be calculated, and the fees that you are going to charge is being calculated upon this one. Now each and every company is looking at this financial advantage. For example, if you check each and every organization nowadays, they are developing this website. Initially they didn't have it, but now they are coming up. Now why they are coming up with the website, and the website is not being managed by the organization, it is given to the cloud. So the website gives us a very clear picture that what services have been there and is it worth for me going to that particular place. Now it is going to decide the customer and the feedback given by them to improve the services provided by the organization. It can be any organization, it can be the hotel, it can be the school, it can be even the college, right? Or it can be any business organization or any other things. So this is going to add up the advantage. Now financial is going to give us a very clear picture that this particular investment is going to fetch me this much amount, and this is how it is going to support the expenditure of them. The next one is a selection of the cloud service provider. The cloud service provider is very much important. I need to see that which type of the provider I am looking at, right? The service I am looking at, so that it is easy for any provider or the consumer, whoever is taking the services, he may add up the services, or if he is not interested, he may easily terminate that one. It shouldn't be a problem. Many a times it so happened that even after the subscriptions and all, still they try to give you the free services, right? You need to see that, is it really worth taking up the free services or no? And the last one is service level agreements. In the service level agreements, we need to see that how much the services we are requesting and how much is being provided by the providers, and is it really matching the attributes they have been said to us or they have been promised to us in terms of the availability of the data, in terms of the confidentiality of the data, or anytime if in case there is a network issues and all, are they still providing us all those services? So before adapting all this one, each and every consumers have to see that, or any of the organization have to see that, whether really they have to adapt this one or no, right? Now if you check that each and every organization or every business unit is adapting these clouds, it can be in terms of the private clouds or it is in terms of the public cloud. Maximum they are private because it is essential or it is very confidential data, especially the government agencies, right? The business units, they have been using up these private clouds. Now when we take up the schools, the hotels, the smaller business units, they are all using the public clouds because the capital investment is very less and the maintenance, that is operational expenditure, is very less. So they are looking at the public clouds, and because of which their organizations are also doing very well. So these are all the considerations we are looking into before we adapt the cloud. So any new change in the technology, we need to first question is that, do we really have to adapt this? If I adapt, then what is the reason or what are the key consideration, that is the success I can reach by applying this one? Hope the concepts are clear for you people. If in case you have any doubts, then you can just drop the questions in the comment box. Thank you.